This, I think, is a pretty cool idea.
This one's going to be good.
You know, we had yesterday a friend from Hers stop in, and they brought the Mix.
Loved it.
Brand, which, you know, put like salt and vinegar and barbecue chips together.
Three new brands.
There are cereal options in this way. New Kellogg's Mashup Cereal is hitting store shelves, and everybody's going to want to buy an extra box. It's a limited edition cereal that combines two favorite iconic brands into one tasty treat. So, the Kellogg's Mashup Cereal puts Frosted Flakes and Fruit Loops into one box.
Not enough sugar for me.
Mm-hmm. You can add sugar to it.
No, it's
we used to add sugar
to Frosted Flakes.
Already sugary cereals.
Really?
Oh my God, yes.
Hey, I see these things on like Instagram and stuff all the time, and I can't remember how the video ended, so maybe you guys can refresh my memory. Maybe you saw this as well. Somebody was taking cereal and they put it in one of those food processors.
So here it is.
And then, okay. Oh.
That story right here. Parents are getting creative when it comes to occupying their children. There's a woman on TikTok that shared how she makes edible sand for her kids.
That's it.
By grinding up Cheerios in a blender.
Edible sand.
I got you, bro.
Yeah. Thank you, man.
And though it's a method of making sensory play sand that's been online for years, a lot of parents apparently did not know about it before this particular post. Many commented that it's the perfect solution if they had a child that is too young to understand that they should not eat sand. And the post also...
You eat sand.
You ate sand. The post also inspired other moms to share videos of how they make the Cheerios sand and give their kids kitchen items to play with, not chicken items.
Wait a second, what was that? You're telling me that sand is made from chickens?
No.
What were you supposed to say?
Kitchen.
Chicken.
Oh, that's like Girl Interrupted. She had a eat-in chicken. Do you remember that?
Eat-in chicken.
Brittany Murphy's character.
She was stashed
chicken
bones under her bed.
And she kept calling her kitchen an eat-in chicken.
Oh, really?
Yes.
No, I didn't catch
that. I don't remember much from that movie, but those are the two things that I remember.
But, Steve, you know what I was thinking while we were looking at sand made from Cheerios? You could also take your beloved cheese puffs and grind those up and make like an orange sandy.
That's actually excellent.
Thing.
I do love those cheese puffs. You know, and the new thing from her is the
Dippin' Dots balls?
Yes, the Oreo. And
you could do that?
Oh, my God, they're so good.
And that's sand you could eat.
When there was no meat, we ate fowl. And when there was no fowl, we ate crawdad. And when there was no crawdad to be found, we ate sand.
You ate what?
We ate sand.
You ate sand?
That's right.
So, you can't, Cage is so good in that. You what?
Raising Arizona is probably his best movie. I think that every cereal naturally produces its own dust, right? And Cheerios dust is probably the worst out of all of them. You choke on it. But, Steve, you mentioned Frosted Mini-Wheats. And the dust that's created by Frosted Mini-Wheats is its own little delectable treat.
It's wonderful.
And you can pour it on top of the cereal. You can have it in its own bowl
of milk.
It's
almost like its own garnish.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
It's its own little dessert. But I don't know why the Cheerios dust is so disgusting. I'm glad that babies are enjoying it, but I don't find it particularly
enjoyable.
Well,
now you can turn it into sand.
Yeah.
So you can eat sand.
You know what, like, thinking of that, yes, as a kid, and especially Frosted Mini-Wheats, my kids will take some kind of food, whatever it is, and just mush it to death.
No.
And just, my son will sit there and just mix and mix. This is Carter. Mix, just mush and smash and smash. I'm like, dude, what are you doing?
Stop that.
It's gross.
But you know what I used
to him, it's not.
Yeah. What I used to do as a kid and I loved was mushing my ice cream up into like a very fine...
Like a paste?
Like sand?
Almost like a paste. But you would have to eat it before it really melted. But kids in sand, they, you know, at a certain point, you know, you have to sort of like age into hating sand in your mouth.
Right.
Because kids, like up to a certain age, like they don't mind it at all.
Most people stop eating sand at around 18.
Okay. Well, some people are pointing out that this might actually teach children that they can eat sand.
That's what I was thinking. Yeah. I didn't want to be like the Debbie Downer, but I'm like, this is a way that they're going to get to the beach and take a handful of sand in their mouth.
You raise a good point, Kathy, because you remember the Play-Doh Fun Factory or whatever it was that replicated where you could make little dough burgers and stuff like that?
Food.
They said that had a side effect that's, I guess I can eat all of this stuff that I play with.
Well, and right. that Play-Doh comes in such vibrant colors. If you made a burger with like nice tomato and like, lettuce,
that looks
good.
Pretty tasty.
Yeah.
But then again, if they try taking a fistful at the beach in their mouth, they'll go, I don't take that care.
However, we had somebody in Kathy. Was it your friend who ate sand?
No, it was my cousin's. Well, it's now his ex-wife. It was my cousin's wife, and my other family members went over to their house for dinner once, and we knew she was a little off a rocker. But she, you know, served everyone else dinner, and she didn't have anything on her plate. And so someone said, "Are you not eating with us?" She goes, "Oh no, I don't eat that. I'll be right back." And this is a true story. She went outside and she scooped up sand from her beds. I guess flower beds. She had sand out back. And she put it on a plate and she came in and they said she was spooning it into her mouth and like you could hear her crunching on the sand while they were sitting there for dinner that she had prepared for them, but she didn't eat it.
It's called pica, right?
Yes, where you like PICA.
Hey, we were watching, Caroline was watching the other day, My Strange Addiction.
Oh really? God,
yeah. And there was a woman whose thing was,
oh no,
she liked to eat Vicks VapoRub. And my daughter has no reference as to how gross that is. I'm like, you have no idea.
I have it right here.
Horrible that
I'll
stuff.
I'll try
is.
A little bit.
Yeah.
No, you're gonna eat it.
Stop it.
It doesn't taste good.
What does the warning say? Does it say it's okay?
Do not even joke about this. Don't place a little bit on your tongue.
And there was another woman who, Kathy, would eat makeup. That was her thing.
Oh.
Like eyeshadow.
Eyeshadow,
like
the powdery. Yeah,
the powdery stuff.
Yeah.
She had like green all over her
that's
mouth
disgusting.
And stuff.
That's so stupid.
I got it, man.
Lip gloss, though, right? That the stuff that smells good, you can eat that, right?
I don't know.
I mean, I wouldn't chow down on it, but it goes on your lip. So
yeah,
I'm sure
so it's not
going to
be poisonous
something.
Or
yeah.
anything along those lines.
That's like Ulta Cosmetics for many is kind of like a luncheonette.
Does that smell edible?
I remember as a younger man, maybe even a child, I probably ate some of that stuff.
I remember when I used to eat cosmetics. I was a younger man back then. I would have a Rouge burger.
It had to smell like food, though.
Okay.
So, but you know how, and what cosmetics do smell like food?
Lip gloss. Yeah, like a vanilla cherry lip gloss, cherry, yeah.
Okay, I got you.
Yeah.
So you did, didn't you?
Yeah, you got me roast beef, right?
Yeah, I got you.